Here's an overview of what you'll do and learn in this walkthrough. You will go end-to-end from raw data in a database to a deployed model with a monitored API endpoint using multiple core DataRobot capabilities along the way. From the provided data connection, you'll ingest data, wrangle it, and materialize a new training dataset. Then you'll develop multiple models, compare them on a leaderboard, and dig into their insights. From there, you'll pick one model, register it, and produce templatized compliance documentation. Next up is the DataRobot one-click deployment process to create an API endpoint and instrument all the deployment monitoring. Lastly, you'll do inference on a batch of data and examine the deployment's health and drift. This walkthrough covers the full machine learning lifecycle with DataRobot. From the homepage, click on the person icon in the upper right and select Data Connections. Notice that your DataRobot trial account has an existing connection to a data warehouse in Snowflake, named Trial Read Only WH. Then return to the NextGen homepage. From the homepage, select Workbench and then create a use case. Name it Hospital Readmissions. Select Add and then Data. Select Demo Connection next to the Snowflake icon, and then click on Trial Read Only. Find the row corresponding to hospital readmissions data, and notice that it has 10,000 rows. Click on the name to bring up a data preview showing the first 100 rows. Then don't click Add to Use Case. Instead, click Wrangle. What's the difference? Only use Add to Use Case when you want the entire table, and database tables can get very big. Use Wrangle to minimize data movement and build models on a subset of the data. DataRobot Wrangler is a visual interface for executing data transformations at the source, leveraging the compute environment and distributed architecture of the data source, in this case Snowflake. Notice the labels Dynamic and Live Random Sample. Proceed to acquaint yourself with some of the data. This is hospital inpatient data for a mixture of demographic segments who have entered the hospital through different admission sources and who have been diagnosed with various conditions. The target to predict is the column named readmitted, which is true if the patient needed to return to the hospital after being discharged. With recipe highlighted, click Add Operation, then Filter Row. With Keep Matching Rows checked, type Discharge Disposition ID in the top box. Then select Contains and type SNF in the third box. SNF stands for Skilled Nursing Facility. According to the histogram, it's about 12% of all the rows, and reducing the dataset is going to make the modeling much faster for demonstration purposes. With recipe highlighted, click Add New Operation and explore the other wrangling options available. Note that Join allows you to combine data from multiple sources, and Compute New feature is infinitely flexible to define any calculation. From Recipe Actions, select Publish. Keep Publish to Data Registry highlighted and click Publish. This action applies your recipe to all the source data and creates the output dataset. DataRobot will advance automatically to this view, and you'll have a short wait while the dataset registers. The 1190 rows and 52 features are in line with expectations. Click the name of the dataset to view it in full. Notice that the recipe SQL can be viewed and copied. Then, from Data Actions, choose Start Modeling. This action takes you to the interface for setting up a new experiment. For the target feature, type readmitted. Review the options for modeling mode, optimization metric, and training feature list. Click Additional Settings and review the partitioning method and validation type. If you're unsure about any of these, know that DataRobot will always default you into data science best practices. The experiment summary panel on the right contains all the metadata for your experiment. This cannot be changed once modeling begins. When everything looks good, click Start Modeling. The automation is now in control. DataRobot will apply your partitioning settings, pre-process the numeric, categorical, and text data separately, select the machine learning algorithms that are suitable for your problem type and data type, and then start testing them one by one. It's as if you've handed your experiment to a team of top-tier data scientists, and you'll come back later to review all their work and results. No further input is needed from you at this point, and you can walk away and come back later. If you close the browser or exit the application, the work will continue. The time it takes for the experiment to complete depends on the amount of starting data and the number of concurrent jobs that your account allows. At this point, two models are finished and two are building. You can view what's in the queue by expanding the jobs queue on the right. Get in touch with your account executive if you want to increase the number of concurrent jobs running in your account. The panel on the left contains the leaderboard. The models are sorted by performance on a specific metric for a specific partition. Models on the leaderboard displaying a metric are fully complete. Select any one that interests you. Click to select it, and also mark it with a star to find it easily later. Start by expanding the blueprint. Notice the pathway that your text, numeric, and categorical data has traveled. Each of these boxes is clickable, bringing up summary information. Click on DataRobot Model Docs for even more detail. Close the blueprint view and open Feature Impact. Click Compute to request this computation. It is added to the queue, but may not be immediately visible if other jobs are ahead of it. Let's request a few other computations and then come back to explore. Open Feature Effects and click Compute. Repeat again for the individual prediction explanations. Now click ROC Curve to expand this panel. Explore the many standard metrics and visualizations offered, including confusion matrices, precision recall, and the ROC Curve itself. The insights provided in these panels are available for all models on the leaderboard. Familiarize yourself with the other insights offered by visiting the panels that interest you. Information about each one is available from the info icon. Also, return to the panels where you requested additional computations to see those results. Feature impact, feature effects, and individual prediction explanations using SHAP values provide standardized explainability and transparency for simple and complex model approaches alike. At this point, there are 10 models on the leaderboard to compare. To see more, select the Rerun Modeling icon and choose the Comprehensive mode. Once completed, you'll have 2 to 3 times as many to browse through. The next step is to select one model and register it. With your desired model highlighted, select Model Actions and then Register Model. Keep Create a New Registered Model selected, optionally update the other fields, and click Register Model. DataRobot will advance automatically to this view. You're now inside the registry in the model directory. Once registration is complete, you'll see the V1 tag and the Ready for Deployment tag underneath the registered model name. The registry contains all the model metadata at a glance for governance purposes. Notice the summarized list of IDs, metrics, and training parameters, and the helpful list of related items. Perhaps the most powerful feature you'll find here in the registry is DataRobot's automated compliance documentation. To try it out, click on Documents and then Generate Document. Mark the radio button next to the built-in template and request it by clicking Generate. Note that you can provide your own company's template to appear in this list. The resulting document is available for download as an editable file and for viewing. Scroll through the contents and appreciate how much time is saved per model by freeing data scientists from writing and documenting, which they hate doing anyway. Click outside the document area to dismiss it. In the upper right, Notice the small download icon with flyover text that says download.mlpkg. This is how you take the entire registered model blueprint, pre-processing and all, and deploy it in environments outside DataRobot. That is out of scope for today. To deploy the registered model within DataRobot, click Deploy. Your screen should match mine if you're working in a trial account and this is your first model you're deploying. DataRobot provides trial users with the ability to create a serverless prediction environment on the platform. First, fill in a name for the environment, then select DataRobot Serverless from the platform drop-down menu, and click Add New Prediction Environment. If you have the appropriate credentials, feel free to set up any of the other environments in the list instead. Briefly scan the deployment settings, including the timestamp, importance, batch monitoring, and advanced options. Accept the default values and click Deploy Model. That's the whole deployment process. DataRobot condensed a multi-week process for an expert team into a single click action. If you've never deployed a model the long, hard way, it's difficult to appreciate the time savings and process standardization in what you just did. DataRobot will now automatically advance to this view. Now you're in the console, viewing the deployment overview for the newly created deployment. Scroll down to see the first automatic entries in the deployment log for governance purposes. Select Monitoring and notice that the service health monitoring has been instrumented by the automation. It's just showing all zeros because the deployment hasn't been used yet. In the predictions area, there are several options for making those first predictions. The prediction API endpoint is ready to use. The scripts provided allow you to make predictions from the command line or from inside another application. Back in the Make Predictions view, there is a link for configuring batch job definitions. For data residing in Snowflake, this would be the most logical choice. However, your trial account does not have the necessary database write access to do this. So, to proceed, click Choose File within the dotted rectangle, then select Data Registry. Select the more recent Wrangle dataset and click Confirm. Slide the toggle next to Include Prediction Explanations on, and accept the default values that populate underneath. At the bottom, click Compute and Download Predictions. Your prediction job is queued, and you'll get a success notification such as this one when it's done. Download the results using the download icon and open them with an application that supports viewing CSV files. The first two columns are the predicted probabilities from the binary classification model. Several columns are devoted to the three requested explanations. And to the right-hand side, you'll find all of the actual prediction data for inference. Back in the console, select the monitoring menu and notice that 1,190 predictions are logged. They appear as a single spike in the line chart below. Choose Data Drift from the menu on the left. Select a feature at random from the Feature Details drop-down list. Click on any point in the scatter plot on the left and notice that the bar chart is interactively connected. Scroll to explore the other drift visualizations, which will make more sense once more batches have been scored, since the x-axis on these is time. Scroll up again and from Feature Details, select Diag 1 Description. This will bring up the text drift visualization. Highlight any individual item in the word cloud for quantitative information on how the word has drifted. Notice that you can add custom metrics from the left menu. This is where a hospital might calculate a business metric, such as the financial impact from patients that need to return to the hospital after discharge. Click on Mitigation and notice that the deployed model is marked as the champion. This is where you can add challenger models to compete with your champion. A full review of deployment functionality is out of scope for this walkthrough. Explore the various menus and settings for your live deployment and consult the documentation to understand the capabilities in each area. To recap, if you've followed this entire walkthrough, you should now have in the workbench area one use case named hospital readmission. Inside, you'll have a wrangling recipe, you'll have a materialized dataset from applying that recipe, and you'll have the experiment, which contains all of your model blueprints. Inside the experiment, you'll have multiple models, and for each model, you'll have many available insights. Inside the registry, you'll have multiple global models, and then your newly added user model at the top. This will be on version 1 for that registered model. This model is deployed. You'll see all of your deployed models in the console. Here's the one deployed model in the one prediction environment that you created, and a job history showing successful completion of this single batch. We hope this gives you a better understanding of going end-to-end in DataRobot across wrangling, building, registration, deployment, and batch scoring. Please take a moment to rate the quality of this learning content, and happy modeling.